Morning, everybody. Happy New Year, almost. It's Sunday afternoon, December 29th, and I'm out in the garage again today. And I thought I would show you guys a technique that I've developed, learned, how to install these barbed fittings into the nylon fuel hose that's used on the Jaguar E-Types, both in the engine compartment and in the boot trunk area where the banjo fittings are used on an a hard line or a hard fitting to a flex hose, and then another barb fitting here. So I've already installed this one, but I thought I'd show you guys my technique. I didn't develop this myself. I learned it from Jerry Mouton, who's in Palo Alto. He's the guy that came and helped me put my motor in. You guys might remember Jerry had his finger bandaged up that day. So, this line is really, really stiff. And if you try to just shove this thing in here, you're gonna make a mess. It's just not gonna happen. So the technique that Jerry talked about was he took a 2x4 and drilled a hole in it, and then, or split a 2x4 and drilled a hole in it, so that the hole was about just a squeech, just a smidge under the size of the hose, so that it would clamp it. And so I developed something similar out of just a couple of little scraps of wood. And here, I'll show it in the light. You can see this one I drilled. This one I used a round file and just sort of filed it out so that it's a tight fit. And when I do that, I leave the hose, just proud of the wood by about a half an inch or so. And then I'll clamp it in my vise. So we'll just get that in here. Show you guys what we're going to do. Whoops. Okay. He said, let me just change the angle because you can't see what I'm doing. Oh, can you? Oh, yeah, a little bit. Let's see if I do this. Yeah, there you go. You can get down a little bit. You can see outside that it's a beautiful sunshine day, but again, it's it's 52 degrees in the garage, so it's a little chilly by California standards. We have cold nights here lately. It's been was down in the high 30s the other night, 39 degrees, and then last night it was about I think it was about 45 in the middle of the night. Okay, so I don't need to go crazy clamping this. I'm gonna break out my trusty heat gun, Milwaukee, just for a quick little warm up, just to get it out of the ice cold zone. Doesn't require a lot of heating, because this nylon hose, if you overheat it, you're gonna make a mess. And then I'm gonna take a little WD-40 and spray it on the fitting to add a little lubrication. And then I'm going to use my rubber mallet and just set it down in there. And then once you get it started and drive it down to where it's getting, the barbs are getting close to the wood, then what I do is I release the wood, move it up a little bit, pound it in further. So you'll see me do that as we go forward. Taking the edge off of this stuff. I don't want to get it hot. I just want to get it warmed up to, room temperature-ish. Feels good on my hands. Yeah, we're getting there. That's probably good enough for now. A little sip of coffee. We'll squirt a WD-40 on the fitting. Okay, there you have it. You just set this in here as best we can, get it started. That kind of, it's nice if you can get it just the very beginning started with your fingers if it's possible, but in this case, I don't think I can, so I'm going to drive it. There it goes. Okay. So So as you can see, this is not a super complicated process, but some people come away saying, God, it's really impossible, I don't know how to do it. This couldn't be easier, really. Just one barbed fitting installed in the nylon tubing. And this is in there forever. I mean, to get these out, you literally have to split the hose with a sharp knife. Because the old ones were like that. You couldn't get them out. No way. Pulling them? Never. So, I was out here yesterday all day working on the carburetor installation and the throttle linkages. So I'll bring you back in just a second. I'll show you. I told you I'd give you a close-up of that stuff. Okay, so here you see the installation is now becoming a little more complete with things that you haven't seen before. Is this throttle linkage is now installed, and then each of the this actual drive link here has a little coupling that connects to the actual throttle shaft. So this is the throttle shaft here that has three lever arms on it, one for each carburetor. So there's two that are side by side, and then the one down here for the front carb. And from those arms are these little steel link rods that go down to the actual throttle levers. The shaft is right there, and there's a little lever on the end of the shaft, so you can see there's two on this side that are facing one another, and then there's this one that sort of separate. And then the lever on the other end of the throttle shaft is a spring lever, so there's return springs that are mounted on these little brackets you see down here underneath the carburetor. So there's a good look at the end one, which you can see clearly, the bracket, the spring itself, applying downward tension to close the throttles. The other thing I did is I put the overflow pipes in that were made for me by Joe Curto. So those go on the tops of the float bowls, along with these little ID tags that are apparently missing on a lot of the E-type cars. And we got a little too much light here. Let's see if that helps. Yeah, it's not helping much, but you can there you go. There's the number. It's AUC946C for the central, and F for the front, and R for the rear. So AUC946 is the plate number on those little tags. And the other thing I did is I mounted the fuel feed line, which you can see connects there at the back, and then goes around in this direction to the other two carburetors with this feed line, which I just manufactured. So I just put that feed line together, and that comes from the fuel filter bowl here. So this banjo fitting will go there, and then this I don't know what to call it, compression fitting, I guess, goes on the end of that little pipe stub right there. So I'm going to install that today and get that going. And the more and more I look, one more thing about the overflow pipes that people that know Jags would know is there's a little retaining clip down here next to the fuel filter housing. And I actually installed that with a little rubber grip to kind of hold them in place. The one that you see is real short. The other ones are actually made extra long. I'm just going to try and extend that little one by bending the pipe a little bit. I think I've got enough length on that rear carburetor to bend that pipe just a little bit more, bring it down through the clip a little further. But this is for overflow, so fuel is going to come pouring out of there if for some reason the carburetor's float valves were to stick and it starts to flood. So I want those pipes to go down far enough that the fuel will get off the motor and off the component. I could probably stick a little rubber tube on that or something to extend it further down, which might be another way to do it. I did put my spin-on oil adapter on the other day, which you see there now. So that's threaded for a standard oil filter. And
the ring, you know, the ceiling ring will sit right on this flange area right here, nice and smooth. Nice black anodized. I got that from Cool Cat, the one I had the other day. Just, I don't know where it came from, but it just, you know, rain, I couldn't get it to work. Some other things that I'm working on, I tried to hook up my choke.